Welcome students, now we are moving to a new chapter, cell cycle. Cells have the power or capability to grow and divide. So new cells are formed by cell divisions. Parent cell give their genetic material or passes their genetic material to their daughter cells. So new cells are formed from already pre-existing cells. Chapter cell cycle, we are going to discuss about nuclear division, cell cycle, cell division, and the difference between mitosis and meiosis. First one, nuclear division. Nuclear division is simply the division of nucleus or the division of chromosomes. There are two types of nuclear division, mitosis and meiosis. Okay, in mitosis, the newly formed daughter cells have the same number of chromosomes, whereas in meiosis, the newly formed daughter cells have half the number of chromosomes. Mitosis are in diploid state condition, that is 2N condition, whereas meiosis are in haploid condition or N condition. Usually, meiosis takes place when cell want to grow or cell required replacement or the organism undergo asexual reproduction, the meiosis type of nuclear division takes place. Both the mitosis as well as meiosis is followed by the division of cytoplasm to form a new cell. So the division of cytoplasm is called as cytokinesis. Okay, so division of nucleus is followed by the division of cytoplasm to form new cells. So the division of cytoplasm is called as cytokinesis. So this is about nuclear division. Nuclear division is division of nucleus, that is chromosome, that of two types, that is mitosis and meiosis. In mitosis, the newly formed daughter cells have same number of chromosomes that of parent cell and they are in diploid state, whereas in meiosis, the newly formed daughter cells have half the number of chromosomes as parent cells and they are haploid state. So the division of nuclear division is followed by the division of cytoplasm are called as cytokinesis. So these are about the first part, nuclear division. Now we are moving cell cycle. By definition, cell cycle is a series of events leading to the formation of a new cell. So, it is a series of events leading to the formation of a new cell. Formation of a new cell. Those are called the cell cycle. So, cell cycle includes several phases. G1, S, M phase, G1S, G2, M phase and G0 phase. Okay, so a series of events required for the formation of a new cell are called cell cycle. There are several phases included in cell cycle, G1, S, G2, M and G0. G1 is the first gap phase. S is the synthesis phase, G2 is the second gap phase, M is the mitotic phase, and G0 is a quiescent stage. So these are about the several phases of cell cycle. Now we are moving to the duration of cell cycle. The G1 phase Before that, the eukaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell means our cell, it requires 24 hours for a cell to divide into a new cell. So the duration of cell cycle of a eukaryotic cell, eukaryotic cell is 24 hours. So duration of cell cycle of eukaryotic cell is 24 hours. Mainly the cell cycle is divided into two. Mainly the cell cycle is divided into two. First one, interphase. Second one, mitotic phase. Mitotic phase. G1, S and G2 include interphase, and M phase is the mitotic phase. 95% of the time is taken for the interphase and the last 1 hour is for mitotic phase. So these are about the duration of duration of cell cycle, that is the G1 phase is the largest phase. It requires 11 hours to complete, 11 or 10 to 11 hours to complete the cell cycle, whereas S, synthetic phase, requires 8 hours to complete the cell cycle, and G2 requires 4 hours to complete the cell cycle, and M requires 1 to 2 hours to complete the cell cycle. So mainly in G1, cell growth is takes place. In G1, cell growth is takes place, and in S phase, DNA duplication or DNA replication occurs. Replication occurs, and in G2 phase also cell growth occurs. In mitotic phase, the mitotic division occurs. Mitotic division occurs. And in M phase, that is mitotic division, we know that there are several steps. First stage is prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, and finally cytokinesis. So these are about the duration. The most duration stage or phase is G1 phase. It requires 10 to 11 hours, and S phase required 8 hours. G2 phase required 4 hours. Remaining 1 to 2 hours required M phase. And there is the cell cycle is determined or checked by some checkpoints. Those checkpoints are called as restriction points. Those checkpoints are called as restriction point. And the first restriction point is at the end of G1 phase, whereas the second restriction point is at the end of G2 phase. Okay, so cell cycle is of two, can be divided into two, interphase and mitotic phase. Almost 95% of time is required for interphase. Interphase includes G1, S and G2, whereas a mitotic phase is the M phase, which has only 1 hour is required to complete their cycle. And G1 phase is almost 10 to 11 hours, and mainly cell growth takes place. And first checkpoint is at the end of G1 phase. And S phase is the synthesis phase, where mainly DNA replication takes place. It requires 8 hours to complete the cycle. And G2 is the second gap phase, and mainly cell growth takes place, and it requires 4 hours to complete their cycle. And second checkpoint is found in the end of G2. And last M phase, it, 1 to 2 hours required to complete the cycle. M phase include prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, and finally cytokinesis. Some cells from the G1 may exit to the G0 phase. We are going to discuss what is G0 detail, and G0 is a quiescent stage. Quiescent stage where the cells are metabolically active without proliferation, and G0 is cells can undergo G0 for long period, and the G0 is not a permanent stage. So these are simply the duration of cell cycle. Now we are going to look detailly about each phase. Okay, detailly about each phase. First one, interphase. Interphase. Interphase is the longest part of the cell cycle. It is the longest part of the cell cycle. That is, it includes G1, S and G2. Okay, so longest part of the cell cycle is the interphase. And initially, nucleus appears to be resting, but this is not at all same for all cases. The thread-like chromosomes will disperse. So, thread-like chromosome can be found initially. These thread-like chromosome may disappear. Thread-like chromosome may dispersed. And they may involved actively in the protein synthesis. So these dispersed chromosome may involved in active protein synthesis. So these are about the general things happening in the interphase. So interphase are the longest part of the cell cycle. Thread-like chromosomes may disperse, and these chromosomes may involved in active protein synthesis. Now we can look each phases in the interphase. First one, G1 phase. What are the things happen during G1 phase? G1 is the first gap phase. First gap phase, and it requires 10 to 11 hours to complete their cycle. In G1 phase, cells have 2C amount of DNA. 2C amount of DNA, that is 2 chromosomes amount of DNA in the G1 phase. And cells are metabolically active. All the cells are metabolically active. And cell may grow by producing proteins, lipids and carbohydrates. Also, some cell organelles like endoplasmic reticulum and mitochondria may synthesize or produce the G1 phase. And also we already discussed about cell cycle is controlled by several checkpoints, also called as restriction points. The first checkpoint is found at the end of G1. So these checkpoints may determine cell state, whether the cell will continue the cell cycle and divide, or it may enter the G0 stage, that is quiescent stage. And probably the cell are arrested in G1. Cell may arrested in G1 due to 3 reasons. First one, nutrient deprivation. The cell may arrest in G1 due to nutrient deprivation, lack of growth factors, and finally the metabolic changes occur and which enter into G0 state. So it undergo, the cells undergo metabolic change, and enters G0 stage, that is Q1 stage. So in G1 it is the first gap phase, so it requires 10 to 11 hours to complete. In G1 phase there is 2C amount of DNA is occur, and the cells in the G1 are metabolically active, and those cells are grown by the production of protein, lipid and carbohydrate, as well as cell organelles like endoplasmic reticulum and mitochondria. Some cells may arise in the G1 phase due to nutrient deprivation, lack of growth factors, and some cells may undergo some metabolic changes and it enters to the G0 stage, that is quiescent stage. Some biochemicals in these cells may activate the cell division. They are called as kinases and cyclin. Kinase and cyclins are biochemicals found inside the cell which may activate the cell division. The cyclin act as a major checkpoint which operates in G1. That is, we said that there is a checkpoint in the G1. Those checkpoints are called as cyclin, and this cyclin may determine whether the cell is want to divide or not. Okay, so these are about the first gap phase. First gap phase also called as G1 phase, and it requires 10 to 11 hours to complete the cycle, and it contains 2C amount of DNA, that is 2 chromosome amount of DNA, and the cells in the G1 are metabolically active and they will grow by producing protein, lipid and carbohydrate, as well as some cell organelles like endoplasmic reticulum and mitochondria. Some cells in the G1 may arise in the G1 itself. Those arrest is due to nutrient deprivation, lack of growth factors, and it undergo metabolic changes and it enters to the quiescent stage. Some biochemicals like kinases and cyclin may activate the cell division. Here the cyclin acts as a checkpoint, that is the checkpoint is at the end of G1 phase, and this checkpoint may determine whether a cell want to divide or not, by this checkpoint, and cyclin act as a checkpoint. So these are about the first gap phase or G1 phase. Now we are going to discuss quiescent stage or G0 phase. Quiescent stage or G0 phase. Some cells may exit G1 and enter to G0, where the cells remain metabolically active without proliferation or division. So some cells from G1 may enter to G0. They are metabolically active but no proliferation or no division. Occur in the G0 stage. And cell can exist in G0 stage for long period. So cells can exist in G0 phase for long period. And G0 cell stops growth with reduced rate of RNA and protein synthesis. So in G0 there is reduced rate of RNA and protein synthesis. So cell stops their growth due to reduced rate of RNA and protein synthesis. And the G0 is not permanent. G0 is not permanent. Is not permanent. But some skeletal muscles and mature neurons permanently in the G0 phase. Permanently in G0. Usually G0 is not a permanent phase, but some skeletal muscles and mature neuron may be in G0 phase permanently. Many cells in animals remain in G0 phase unless it requires proliferation by growth factors and other extracellular signals. And mainly the G0 cells are not dormant. G0 cells are not dormant cells. It can undergo division whenever it requires division, it undergo division. The cells are metabolically active in G0 but without proliferation. Whenever the G0 cells require division, it again enter to the G1 phase. So these are about the G0. What is G0 phase? It is simply quiescent state. The G0 cells may exit from G1 and enter into the G0 cells without proliferation. And G0 cells can undergo or can remain in G0 stage for long period. And the G0 cells may stop their growth due to reduced rate of RNA and protein synthesis. Usually G0 is not a permanent phase, but some skeletal muscles and mature neuron may permanently occur in the G0 phase. And cells in G0 are not dormant. So whenever it requires cell division, it may enter to the G1 phase. So these are about G0 phase. Now we are going to discuss about S phase. Discuss about S phase, that is synthesis phase. S phase is simply synthesis phase. The cells with intermediate amount of DNA can be formed. Cells with intermediate amount of DNA can be found in S phase. And mainly growth of cells continuous. Cell growth continues. DNA replication occurs and proteins called histones formed and attaches DNA. And centrioles may duplicate in the cytoplasm. Centriole duplicates. And the 2C amount of DNA 2C amount of DNA is converted to 4C. 2C amount of DNA is converted to 4C. Or 2C amount of DNA increases to 4C. So these are about S phase. So S phase is it requires 8 hours to complete. It requires 8 hours to complete. So it is synthesis phase and cell with intermediate amount of DNA is occur in the S phase. And the cell growth remains continuous and DNA replication occurs in the cells. Some proteins called as histones, they are formed in this phase and attaches to DNA in this phase. And centrioles may undergo duplication in the cytoplasm. The 2C amount of DNA is increased to 4C amount. So these are the events that take place in the S phase. Now we can discuss about G2 phase, otherwise called as second gap phase, and it requires 4 hours to continue, 4 hours to complete their event. Okay, so the 4C amount of DNA is occur in cells of G2 as well as cells of M phase. So 4C amount of DNA may be occur. 4C amount of DNA may occur, and the cell growth continues by protein and cell organelle synthesis. So cell growth continues. Cell growth continues by the formation or synthesis of protein and several cell organelles. Then mitochondria and chloroplast may divide. So division of mitochondria and chloroplast occur. Mitochondria and chloroplast division occur. Then the DNA content may remain as 4C. Synthesis of tubules are formed and formation of microtubules occur. This is tubulin synthesis. Tubulin synthesis and microtubule formation. Microtubule formation occurs in this phase. Microtubule formation occurs in this phase. And the spindle fiber is formed by microtubule organelles. These formed microtubules may organize to form spindle fiber. So spindle fiber forms. These formed spindle fiber may begin to form and nuclear division follows. So tubulin synthesis and microtubule formation takes place, and these microtubule formation may help for the formation of spindle fiber, and these spindle fiber may follow the nuclear division. And a protein called maturation promoting factor. Maturation promoting factor. Maturation promoting factor. So maturation promoting factor is a protein which is formed or synthesized only in G2 phase. What it helps is it helps in condensation of interphase chromosome to mitotic chromosome. So it helps in the condensation of interphase chromosomes to mitotic chromosome. So these proteins may produce only in the G2 phase. And we know that the cell cycle is controlled by checkpoints, and a checkpoint is found at the end of G2 phase. Okay, so these are the events that take place in G2 phase, that is second gap phase. It requires 4 hours to complete this cycle. The force, the amount of DNA may remains in the cells, and cell growth continues by the synthesis of proteins and several cell organelles, and the division of mitochondria and chloroplast may take place, and tubulin synthesis and microtubule formation is occur, and these microtubules organize to form spindle fiber. These spindle fiber may begins to form and nuclear division follows. A special protein called maturation promoting factor, which is formed or synthesized only in the G2 phase, and the condensation of interphase chromosomes to mitotic chromosome may happen with the help of this maturation promoting factor. A restriction point is found at the end of G2 phase. So these are about the events happened on the G2 phase. M phase is simply mitotic phase, or the cell division may occurs in this phase. Okay, M phase contain different stages or several events. First one, prophase, where the chromosomes are condensed. Second one, metaphase, the chromosomes may align as a line at the center of the cell. Third one, anaphase, the chromosome divisions occur and it may separate from the center. Telophase, where the chromosomes may reaches the end or pole of the cells. 5. Cytokinesis, the cytoplasm may divide. So these are the events may take place in the M phase, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase and cytokinesis. And it requires only 1 to 2 hours of the entire duration of cell cycle. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase and cytokinesis, that is M phase. So these M phase can be discussed in our next class. I think you all have got about the cell cycle. If you have any doubt, you may please ask me. So that's all of today. Thank you.